everybody, and thanks for dropping in for this segment of The Matrix with your boy Prime. I'm glad y'all can join me. Well, here's another video of gameplay with me playing NBA Live 16 head-to-head. I think y'all are starting to enjoy my series of games that I do play, and y'all can actually see how it is, how I gets down, and, you know, how I actually, you know, my point of view and my perspective on how the game is broken down. All right, y'all. Well, if you know, you know. But if you didn't know, your boy Prime is always going to bring it to you. All right, y'all. Enjoy the game. Make sure that you rate, comment, and subscribe. And as always, your boy Prime always going to bring it to you. All right, y'all. I'm Ghost. Enjoy the video. Peace. What's up, everybody? I knew it was going to change it. I knew it was going to change it. I knew it. I knew it. I knew it.
All right, as this game gets underway, Jeff, anybody that stands out in your mind that they need to focus on against the Warriors tonight?
You can't speak about Klay Thompson without mentioning Steph Curry.
I knew it was going to change the jersey, but it's all right, though. It's good that it went to white.
I see that.
Why is stuff not activating? I'm sitting right on this shit. Why is it ain't activating? Thank you, because it ain't even activating.
For the layup, gets it to go after a killer crossover.
That's just a nice layup right there.
This season, a huge season for Draymond Green. He was so versatile last year, now has the big contract. Perhaps feels a little pressure that he's got to perform this year.
Money Green is my new nickname for him, Mike. But he deserved it. He earned it.
He shouldn't even got that.
His versatility, his competitive juice had such a huge impact on the Warriors winning. And I don't think there has to be anything to change for his formula of success. He should not feel more pressure to score. Just continue to do his job and do it at a very, very high level.
Pass to the corner. Gasol. What a rejection.
That's a fucking foul. Don't know how the hell he got that.
Curry collects the inbound. Curry draws the double team. Thompson from downtown. Nobody near him.
Yeah, that was fake because I didn't even double team on that side.
3-point range. He's got 5 points in this matchup.
Three ball. Corner pocket.
Converts on the inside.
You need guys who can make shots under duress and pressure. That was a well-defended possession, but that man stuck it. Even against the best defense.
You want to do all the spin shit I see, huh?
Nice shot for two.
You want to do that?
A 2-point shot. Man, is that a thing of beauty.
Forced to make the pass. Moving the ball around beautifully. To Gasol.
This dude ain't playing no D.
The Bulls a perfect example.
He ain't playing no defense. Night in and night out. He's just trying to screed over so he can try and see how I'm looking at his D.
That type of passion, you're in every game.
Absolutely. The misnomer is that defense wins championships, but when you're going through and absorbing injuries the Bulls have had the last couple years, you have to try to stay in games by playing tough as nails defense, and that's exactly the formula the Bulls used to play with great, great success.
Do that pick and pop. Bring it out.
Chicago's leading Golden State by a score of 9-7. Off the screen, pulls up and shoots. The Warriors with the offensive rebound for a second chance opportunity.
Get the rebound, because there's no way.
From beyond the 3-point arc. Pass to the corner. Moving the ball. Excellent teamwork. Looking to curl in. Gets to the rim.
Thank you.
For two. 4-point lead for
Chicago. Ain't playing no damn D.
Control right there. on that layup. Good finish.
Curry jump shot. Puts it in.
Throwing up desperate ass shots.
Hey, that's one
you better pray them lucky ass shots go down, too.
Knocked in a contested 2-point shot.
Dude, man, you better play some goddamn D.
Jeff, we saw glimpses of Derrick Rose.
Stop trying to damn reach.
Special players in the NBA.
There's no question.
Thank you. Saw that dumb shit.
He has got unique talent that doesn't come along very often. And when he's able to knock this rust off that's accumulated over the last few years due to injury, and he can get back to that consistent, efficient play that we've grown accustomed to, he's certainly an elite point guard.
Shoots the three. Gasol the rebound. Green set nicely. Rose on the drive.
Got it. Lucky I missed.
He's averaging 5 rebounds per game this season. Curry. Green's looking to set up in the paint. Curry fires away for 2.
He can have it. That's all he can do. He ain't got nothing else to do. He better hope that shit fall.
Chicago's leading Golden State by a score of 15 to 11. Mirotić. Mirotić against Curry.
I got a mismatch.
Let's it go. Nice touch at the basket.
Good. I got that switch.
Curry fires for 3.
He better just hope it. That shit keep on falling. I'm gonna stop that shit. Where's the mismatch at?
Mirotić. Mirotić for 3. He's
there you go.
Wide open. Nails it from downtown on the catch and shoot.
Hell no.
And the first quarter complete. The Bulls up by 6. We'll have more Friday night NBA from ESPN after the break. Interesting first quarter. Shots falling for both teams. Defense certainly needs to pick it up.
You say interesting. I say disgusting. That defense won't get it done in the NBA. You want to win, you guard people.
Give me that.
Able to convert from the 3-point line.
It's hard to close out on great shooters. Tremendous job right there, getting his hand up, mirroring the ball.
That better fall. That's fake, man. That should have been my rebound.
Jeff, Klay Thompson had that magic.
That should have been my rebound. They just gave you that. You got bailed out on that.
In a single quarter. Remember, he beat the record set by George Gervin and Carmelo Anthony. That was a special night.
It was incredible to watch. When you look back at the 9 3-point shots that he got, there was only one lucky bounce. I mean, he was so
stupid ass.
I wish I was there to enjoy it with the Oracle crowd.
Puts it up for 2. Can't knock it down.
There's no way.
Hold it on the drive. Goes to the goal. Nice finish.
There is no way.
Pound the offensive board. Get extra possession. Great job in the pursuit of the basketball and then finishing at the rim.
Weaves his way to the basket. Off the mark from point blank range.
He better hope I miss all my shots.
Close and get there and then
he better hope I miss. Timeout. Because they cheating.
And they call timeout, ask for a full. What's the thinking here?
When you see the full timeout being taken, oftentimes staffs get together away from their teams to do a number of things. One is to discuss necessary strategy adjustments. Maybe they're discussing matchup adjustments. And sometimes the head coach is just complaining about the players who are in the game at that moment. And as an assistant coach, your job is to nod your head. Yes, up and down vigorously, like you understand the pain that the head coach is going through at that moment. Sometimes it is that simple.
Fred Hoiberg's made a few subs here. Jeff, remember we were talking about Klay Thompson's 37 points in the single quarter Imagine if there was a three-point line when George Gervin was playing. How many would he have scored on a given night?
Yeah, and I think George Gervin has a legitimate beef, Mike. He said, hey, I scored the 33 points without the benefit of the three-point line. It makes you think, do all these records need to have an asterisk next to them when you talk about the three-point line?
You better just keep on hoping that them shots go in, bitch.
Because
you're a lucky bitch.
Of the three-point shot.
Oh, pretty pass from Derrick Rose. That's his third assist.
We're seeing a lot of offensive energy on the floor from both of these teams with terrific ball movement.
And he kicks it out. The catch and fire away from downtown. Can't hit from three-point range.
Even great shooters are distracted by a great closeout and a hard contest.
Rose, and gets it to go.
Chicago's having great success in this game for one simple reason. Offensive awareness. These guys are showing some great chemistry.
Pass to the top of the key. Oh, excellent screen. Closely guarded, still fires for three.
See, that's that bullshit. I'm hard hedging it, and they just keep on doing illegal screens.
You're not going to see a better possession in the NBA from both sides of the ball. Good defense, good offense.
Because he ain't playing no damn D. Out of bounds, dumbass.
Jeff, remember when our buddy Mark was coaching the Warriors and he called Curry and Thompson the greatest shooting backcourt in the history of the game? We mocked him back then, but he might be
that
right.
That should be my ball. What?
There goes that fool talking again. But hey, the fool was right. The Splash Brothers are the absolute best shooting backcourt of all time. Mark Jackson got it right.
And back outside. Thompson on the drive.
Crap out of here, boy.
Curry against Rose. Fires from three-point range. The Warriors with the offensive rebound for another possession. Curry fires yet another.
You better just keep on hoping that these lucky shots keep on falling.
And that's the fifth three-pointer for the Warriors.
Hey, sometimes good offense beats good defense. There's nothing to be ashamed with on that possession.
I rushed that.
Well-defended, well-contested shot.
Thompson fires no. away deep in the
Thank
corner.
You.
Thompson's three-point shot. Won't go.
That's the mark of a great defensive team. Great closeout, great contest. That's the way to get it done.
Dumbass bitch. Doing all this lucky shit.
Defense always has to be blocking out and securing the defensive rebound. Here they didn't do it. Good pursuit on the offensive board and allowed him to stick it.
No way.
Slam over the defense.
The power and force of that dunk was off the charts.
Making the defense work with excellent ball movement. Fires it back out to the perimeter. Slams it home.
This dude trying to do all these damn glitches. It ain't gonna work.
Dunking the ball with strength and force.
Curry has the double team converge. Curling in, inside.
Hell no!
No good.
Closing out defensively is the most important aspect of team defense. Great contest.
To Gibson. Oh, what a play!
Oh, that's nice right there.
Nigga ain't the playing no fucking D.
Nice dunk.
Thank you, dumbass.
And an offensive foul.
That wasn't no offensive foul. He lucky he anticipated because I should have passed him.
Curry on the drive, working off the screen, gets that one to drop. It'll count if it goes.
Don't matter.
The first half comes to an end. Chicago's up by three. Stay tuned for more Friday night. And we're back at the United Center for the second half, which is just about underway. Along with Jeff Van Gundy, Mike Breen on hand. Chicago's got a slim lead as the third quarter gets underway. But Jeff, this one's anyone's game right now.
It is very closely and hotly contested. I like how both teams are playing. They've just got to try to get a little bit more separation with
not a game. Oh, wow.
Well, everybody, I hope y'all enjoyed the game. It was a short game, but unfortunately, I don't know what actually happened. Either he quit out or the servers or everything had messed up. Well, everybody, look at the descriptions below. Make sure you rate, comment, and subscribe. And as always, you always know I'm going to bring it to you up here in the Matrix. And I hope you enjoyed the game. All right, y'all. Subscribe to the channel. I'm out, y'all. Peace.